Text number 24 and 25. Patito bhuvyashrini mishra.
Patito bhuvyashrini mishra.
Vishtabur eva chestate.
Vishtabur eva chestate.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Viparitam gatum gata.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Patito bhuvyan yashrine mishra.
Patito bhuvyan yashrine mishra.
Vishtabhur eva chastate.
Vishtabhur eva chastate.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Patito bhuvyashrine mishra.
Patito bhuvyashrine mishra.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Viparitam gatim gata. Patito bhuvyashrinimishra.
Patito bhuvyashrinimishra.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Roruyati gate gyane.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Viparitam gatim gata.
Patito bhuvyashrinimishra.
Patito bhuvyashrini mishra.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Vistabhur eva chastate.
Roruyati gati janane janane.
Roruyati gati gyane.
Avipraritam gatim gataha.
Viparitam gatim gata. Patita,
patita,
fallen,
fallen,
bhuvi,
bhuvi,
on the earth,
on the earth,
ashrik,
ashrik,
with blood,
with blood,
mishra,
mishra,
smeared,
smeared,
vishtabhu,
vishtabhu,
a worm,
a worm,
eva,
eva,
like,
right.
Chastate.
Chastate.
He moves his limbs.
He moves his limbs.
Roruyati.
Roruyati.
Cries loudly.
Cries loudly.
Gate.
Gate.
Being lost.
Being lost.
Gyane.
Gyane.
His wisdom.
His wisdom.
Viparitam.
Viparitam.
The appropriate.
The opposite.
The opposite.
The opposite.
Gati.
Gati.
State.
State.
Gata.
Gata.
Gone.
Gone.
Translation. The child thus falls on the ground, smeared with stool and blood, and placed just like a worm germinated from the stool. He loses his superior knowledge and cries under the spell of Maya. There's no purport. We'll read the next verse, text number 25. Parachandam na vidusha pashyamano gyanesa anabhipreshtam apana pratyakhyatam aneshvara. Translation. After coming out of the abdomen, the child is given to the care of persons who are unable to understand what he wants, and thus he is nursed by such persons. Unable to refuse whatever is given to him, he falls into undesirable circumstances. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Within the abdomen of the mother, the nourishment of the child was being carried out by nature's own arrangement. The atmosphere within the abdomen was not at all pleasing, but as far as the child's feeling was concerned, it was being properly done by the law of nature. But upon coming out of the abdomen, the child falls into a different atmosphere. He wants to eat one thing, but something else is given to him, because no one knows his actual demand, and he cannot refuse the undesirables given to him. Sometimes the child cries for the mother's breast, but because the nurse thinks that it is due to pain within his stomach that he is crying, she supplies him with some bitter medicine. The child does not want it, but he cannot refuse it. He is put in very awkward circumstances, and the suffering continues. Omagyana tamarandasya yananjana shalakaya chakshurumilitanyena tasmai shri gurave namaha vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa sindhu bhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo nama jai shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda shri advaita gadadhar shri vasadhi gaur bhaktavinda hare krishna hare krishna 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 hare 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 rama hare rama 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 So Lord Kapila is telling his mother about the miseries of birth. We generally like to celebrate our birthday. Actually, we should lament our birthday. We should feel very sorry that we have taken our birth in this material world. We heard about the child in the womb, how he was very uncomfortable. But so long as the child was in the womb, he was cared for. He was getting food from the mother. By the food supplied to the baby was the arrangement of nature. When the mother would take food, then that food, the energy of the food, the nourishment of the food would also go to the child. So the child did not have any problem to worry about his condition. Of course, it was not a very nice condition, but he was being looked after. Just like a prisoner. You put them in the jail. They're put in the prison house. They suffer, but they're looked after.
Uh,
Some people, they are happy to be in the prison. They're happy to go in the jail because in the jail they have a place to stay. They get food and they're looked after. Of course, it's not a very comfortable, very happy environment. But for some people, they'd rather be in jail than in the free. But most people prefer not to be in jail. So the same way the baby in the womb was like a prisoner. Suffering. But after the baby takes birth, then the baby has a little more freedom of its own. But Prabhupada explains that in the beginning, for the child, so much suffering, even after birth. First of all, the birth itself is very painful. But the child has to come out from the womb. So it's crushed, it's pushed, you know. So not a very pleasant experience. And then after we come out, then we have a problem because the baby cannot communicate with people. The child may want to drink the mother's milk. But the child does not know how to say that
to people.
Because the child has to be 2 or 3 years old before they start speaking and communicating. So for the first couple of years, it's misery. Prabhupada gives the example. He said, child may be crying. He wants to drink the mother's milk. But mother thinks, oh, there's something wrong with his stomach. I should give him medicine. And they give some horrible tasting medicine. And the baby is helpless. The baby cannot refuse. So they stick the spoon, they stick the medicine in the mouth. Horrible stuff. It's like that in birth and it's like that in death again. If you go to the hospitals and see the old people dying, you'll see they do the same kind of things. One devotee was in the hospital and he told me he was watching how what they do to the old people. They have somebody to take. They have sometimes wealthy, poor people, old people. Wealthy old people, they have somebody sit there to take care of them, a maid. So the old person is laying on the bed and the maid sits and watches television all day. And the old person is laying on the bed helpless, he doesn't know. And then sometimes they will just stick food in the mouth, it would just... So much suffering, so much misery is there, birth and death. So we want to get free of these things, birth, old age, disease and death. We don't want to have to suffer all this all the time. We want to get free. This Krishna conscious process is the way how we can get out. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Janma karma cha me devyam eva myo vedi takmada atak vadeham punar janma naiti mamiti sojana. Krishna is saying if we understand his birth and his activities to be transcendental, then we never have to take birth again.
Krishna bhava tata kojai wa Krishna kankar kong Krishna la kichakam kong Krishna va pentip thakajam me karma ne lok ni.
We should want to get out of this material world. But so many people are just trying to be comfortable here in this world. They're trying to make a permanent home here. But everyone has to die. Right. Everybody's going to die sooner or later. We should be thinking where to go in the next life.
A
devotee wants to go back to Godhead, back home, back to Godhead. We want to go and be with Krishna. We want to enjoy the spiritual world. So to go there to the spiritual world, qualification is we have to develop some attraction for
Krishna.
We have to follow Krishna's instructions. We have to give up our interest in all this mundane world. All of our interests, studying, like, we're studying so many things. We have to give up our interest in trying to enjoy this world. Our nice apartments, our property, our money, our youth. We have to become detached from all of this.
Mm-hmm.
And to become detached from all of it, we have to develop an attachment for Krishna. Krishna has a spiritual body. He appeared in this world and he transformed himself into a young baby and he grew up into the young man. So Krishna grows to the form of youthhood, then he never grows older than that. Even when he's a grandfather with many children, grandchildren, but he never looks older than the young man. So we would all like to be like Krishna and have that body which never grows old. So we can have a spiritual body. We can go there and have a body like Krishna. That's a type, one kind of liberation. But we shouldn't be envious of Krishna. We should want to serve
Krishna.
And the best way to serve Krishna is by chanting his holy name and studying Srimad Bhagavatam. We have to associate with the devotees. We have to chant and dance in the service of Krishna. So in this way we can enjoy our spiritual body. So Lord Kapila is describing there's no pleasure in this material body. When the mother gives birth to a child, she's so happy. But the child is not happy. Child just crying. Then of course mother has to take the child and she feeds the child her milk. And then the child goes to sleep. So the young baby, for the young baby, they can't do anything except eat and sleep. So this is called anamoya. Anamoya is one kind of realization, realizing God in the form of food. We have to learn how to use everything like that in the service of
Krishna.
So we should understand the miseries of the birth and death. And we should not want to come again in this world. Said when mother and father want to have a child, they should think like that. They should think this child will not take birth again. In the this will be his last birth.
If
So that is this, that is the goal, that is Krishna conscious family life. Mother and father are having a child, so that child can go back to
Godhead.
It is said, don't become a mother and a father unless you can deliver your child from birth and death. Don't become a teacher unless you can deliver your student from birth and death. So everyone should feel some responsibility in this human life. And real responsible people, they will use this human life to get free from material existence, to go beyond birth and death. We should constantly be thinking like that. Krishna, praying to Krishna, don't let me get stuck again in this material world. Get me out of here. Let me out of here. Just like if you go in the public toilet sometimes.
It's
so horrible place. You just want to get out. But you have to do some business
here.
So you do your business quick and get out. You don't fool around, you don't waste your time. So we should see the material world like that. Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Srila Prabhupada ki. Srila Prabhupada ki. Srila Prabhupada ki.